So have you wondered how Ram in the Ramayana earns money, or how Krishna in the Bhagavata earns money? How do Pandavas earn money? These are questions that we keep asking, or at least I ask. We normally just take these for granted, ki paise kahin se to aate hain. People just get money from somewhere. But if you wear an economic lens and you start looking at the Puranas, you start thinking about these things, you start asking questions. And let's ask ourselves, how do we earn money? You know, either you start a business or you take up a job. And that's one simple way of explaining. Either you create jobs or you do a job. Another way of looking at it is that, you know, there are primary industries, that means farming, animal husbandry, which involves plants and animals, and mining, minerals. There is secondary industry, which is manufacturing, and then there is tertiary, which is trading, and there are other kind of more sophisticated industries nowadays emerging, like banking, where you invest and enable traders and businessmen to trade and to manufacture things. How is it explained in the Puranic space? In Puranic space, they would always look at, you know, for example, Krishna. Krishna is called a Gopala, one who takes care of cows. Why is he taking care of cows? Because that is the source of income for the cowherd community in Vrindavan. So he is providing a service to his parents. His parents, Nanda and Yashoda, have cows, and he herds the cows, takes them to pasture lands. That is where the cows eat grass so that they can produce milk, and this milk is then sold in the markets of Mathura. Or the milk is turned into butter, or the milk is turned into ghee, and it is sold. So it's a product that will be sold in the markets of Mathura. So Krishna is part of an economic ecosystem. Krishna's brother Balaram is not associated with cowherding. He is always shown holding a plow in his hand. He's called Haladhara, one who holds the plow in his hand. Why is the plow there? In order to plow the field. So he's plowing. So it's a primary industry. He's going to plow the field. And he has a musala or a pestle. And a pestle is used to pound grain. And that is how you de-husk grain. So he is involved in activity which is associated with agriculture. So suddenly you see that the Krishna and his brother Balaram are associated with activities in the village. Well, Ram is a king. What kind of job he does? How does he earn his income? Is it through taxation? Or is it because he's a Kshatriya, he owns land, and therefore that is his wealth which comes from the land? Or is it a tax that he pays? And in the Manusmriti and in the Arthashastra and in the Buddhist traditions, in the various Jatakas, you have this concept that a king is actually providing a service. He creates an ecosystem for everyone where everyone can do their jobs. In exchange, he gets a percentage of everybody's wealth, which we call tax. So even a king is earning money for the service he provides. So everybody has to earn money.